And open to becoming more participative in the healing resources of the Triune God. This congregation is one of the few congregations in Lutheranism that believes within the Lutheran tradition, healing by the Triune God is as powerful as healing through any other medical resources. And so I've learned much as I have been involved with you, and part of what I've learned is will become some manuals. The one that we did the last already has been requested by two churches, one in Lititz and one in Texas, to learn how to have a healthy soul workout. And so I thank you for this chance to see that what we have participated here in Zion already, because of you being pioneers in healing, being available to other churches. Much of what I have learned, I have been taught from people who are sick. And as I have learned this, then God has seen that these services become available to people when they're going through tough times also. One of the healing practices is the breathing prayer. Just as God breathed into the soil and the soil became a living soul, so today we participate in the breathing prayer. And interestingly, guess what? The secular world and the sports world use the breathing prayer more than the Christian community. What is yoga? Learning to breathe in an appropriate way. Guess what athletes do? As a way of preparing, take a deep breath so they can be centered and focused. So would you enjoy and participate with me in the breathing prayer? For a few moments, simply to appreciate breathing in fresh air and breathing out used air. And as we breathe in fresh air to offer the silent prayer, Christ always, and as we exhale used air to offer the silent prayer, heals me. Breathing in and praying, Christ always, breathing out and praying, heals me. Thank you, God, for giving us our human breath from the very first breath when we came into this world until the last breath when we return to our heavenly home. You give us the rhythm of breathing in and breathing out. And then for those of us who become part of your family through baptism, through seeing God's love in our daily lives, through a relationship with the Holy Spirit that gives us energy every breath, we receive a second breath, your breath, the breath of the Holy Spirit, the breath of God. As our human breath and the holy breath intermingle, we are doubly blessed. And as our body gets older, and our human breath becomes more difficult, the breath of God becomes even stronger and gives us spiritual energy, which keeps us going through your love for us. In the community of the Trinity, we pray. Amen. God wants to heal us. Yes, but not me. For what we just prayed is heretical. It's heretical because in our American culture, we have come to believe that healing and curing occurs primarily through medicine and taking pills and other kinds of therapies. God works behind them, for the triune God is the source of all healing. But many times we rely on those kinds of resources when God also wants to give us healing that comes directly from the triune God. Notice that James is indicating an interesting issue. When Jesus was walking on this earth, we could see Jesus healing people directly. But since Jesus is not with us and Jesus was not with James, James had to figure out a way to answer the question, but not yet. So James went ahead and identified several ways by which we take visible things and let them come into our inner life and heal the troubleness that's inside of us. As we are cheerful, so we're to sing hymns. And so we come together to express that gift of cheerfulness by worshiping today. And we see that is already one of the gifts of healing. But at the same time, James is indicating we are hurt, we have difficulties that affect us. You and I, since we're primarily a one age group here in this service, have a body that is so, except you. And there's one other person, Alyssa back there. The rest of us, I'm speaking now, heart to heart to our, oh, Stan is younger and Janice is younger. Oh, that's right. He just turned 50. I forgot. See, we're related. So we celebrated his 50th birthday and Labor Day. And what a joy it was, because he is such a joyful person. And that's a blessing to the Shilling family. So you and I have a human body that is finite. It's weak. Our humanity slows us down. And James is saying then, are you hurt? Are you suffering? And these are questions then that we begin to ask ourselves. Yes, but is it a reality that as I ask these questions, I say yes, but not me. I am the one that this is not to be. And we do that because we look out of a certain kind of lens in our glasses. I had double cataract surgery earlier this year, and it helped my sight great. Things were brighter, I could see better, but I needed to have lens because I have severe astigmatism. So I have two kinds of lens, one to see a distance and the other to see the computer and read. So this past week, Marlene and I were going someplace, and I began to say, Marlene, I can't see. My eyes have already become blurry. Things look foggy. When I look out there, I can't see the 35-mile number like I used to. My eyes have changed. I got to go see the doctor. And then I came home, and I realized I had put on the glasses for reading and the computer. I had the wrong glasses on. That's what happens to most of us. We wear wrong glasses and see things from the view of the world rather than see things from the eyes of Jesus. And so Jesus is indicating to us as he holds out his hand, we have all kinds of services to give the people of God when we are willing to take the hand of God and put our hand in that hand. And as we do that and let God's hand work with our illness as well as with all the other good things that God uses in God's good world to help us become well, we begin to see then life in a different way. And one of the ways we begin to see it is through an interesting two words, as, so, rather than yes, but not me. As I am sick, so Jesus comes and touches me. As I am in the hospital and I have a hard time breathing, so the breath of God comes to me and gives me strength. So we want to look at the different ways that James is illustrating we are to receive. For a healing life is based not on what you and I achieve or possess. A healing life is based on what we are willing to receive. Sidebar. This is very hard for us men. We have been brought up to be self-sufficient. We have been brought up that when we are hurting inside, to stuff it until the body yells out and screams. Just watch what happens in football and all the other sports. With people who are caught up in the stress of life, we men stuff it. The reality is, though, that when we are people of God, when we are troubled, Jesus says one of the best services of healing is prayer. Not the prayer of a person who is sick, but the prayer of the person who is part of a healing community. And by being part of that healing community, that person is to pray on our behalf. And so we see that you have all kinds of ways that you, as a healing congregation, that people can indicate their need for healing, just like we see this man there with the child. Who is doing the praying? Who is touching the little one? So that the prayer of a person of faith is having their hand connect with the hand of God, and the healing goes through that person and connects with the person who is sick. And it's a healing energy that comes to us through the Holy Spirit. Healing is always relational, never in isolation. Too many of us, when we get sick, we withdraw from the healing community. But Jesus comes to where we are and sits down, and we imagine and see with the lens and eyes of God that Jesus is talking with us. And Jesus is touching our deepest inner pain. And through that voice that we hear inside of us, Jesus said, as you are sick, so I provide the services to heal you. And two of the very powerful ways that we practice here in this congregation is the laying on of hands. A deep tradition in the Old Testament and the New Testament. Because what God is indicating, that as we lay hands on each other, the energy of the Holy Spirit connects with each other, and the power of healing becomes even greater because we are connected with that which is life-giving. Along with the laying on of hands, there is the anointing with oil. What does Psalm 23 say? Thou anointest my head with oil. What's the result of it? My cup runneth over. Oil is a solution that then, as we use it with the sign of the cross, provides that transfusion of energy that enables our body to receive that which is so strong. As James says, the greatest power of all becomes that which connects with the triune God and gives to us spiritual energy. I've experienced it. I was going through a very deep depression, so depressed that I really felt inside I was weak, I had very little energy, that I didn't want to get up in the morning, all those signs of a clinical depression. The trouble is that I'm such a good German, my wife did not even know I was sick, inwardly, because outwardly I was pretending everything was okay. So I went to this church where we were members in Camp Hill years ago, where we had a monthly service of healing and prayer. And as I knelt down to receive the laying on of hands and anointing with oil, the heaviness in my heart was lifted, not by me, but by the visible expression of laying on of hands, anointing with oil, that touched that which is so heavy that I was released from that burden and received the energy that comes to us through those outward symbols whereby we are given life. And thus we ask ourselves, in what ways does God heal you and me? What are any of those ways that you're able to finish that sentence and say, yes, though my body is aging, though my body has a physical ailment, I am well through the triune God. And guess who are the people that say that, who have taught that to me? People who have chronic illnesses. Not people that are physically healthy, but people that know that they may not be cured of their physical illness, but they are well and whole through the resources. So as we come to this service, before you leave this service, think back and see how many resources of the triune God has been expressed in this service. And how have we received them to be made well? For it is always relational, people coming and sharing together. Now, the sad thing is, the reality is that when you and I get sick, we call the doctor, we go get tests, we go through the medical pathway, but 90% of our people in the church do not call the church for the prayer of healing. We do not finish that sentence with the over 90 services, resources, that the triune God provides for our healing. And thus we become aware, as we see in that one picture that is so powerful, where the patient is in the surgery, in the operating room, and guess who is also there? One of the members last night came out and said, Pastor Fred, when I had bypass surgery, a person sent me that picture of Jesus being in the operating room. And that image is what kept me going through the surgery and through the recovery. Then we become aware, as Christ loves me, so I am healed. And we find ways to have that as, which names our condition, that it leads to the so, by which the triune God brings that life-giving healing to each one of us. For Jesus is with us always. As we have the image of God in each one of us, so the presence of Jesus is always there. Amen.